see, because it is transverse vibration, so in transverse vibration we have transverse displacement, right? Just a minute, I'll change the page so that you can see here. Oh, I have erased the form, the diagram. Actually, when your beam will vibrate in this direction and in this direction, then you have displacement transversely, right? Or you can say laterally. So lateral displacement, transverse displacement is also giving you direction. So in the beginning itself, I told you that y is the function of x and y is the function of y. Sorry, time. So x and time, they both contain their own equations. So your yx contains a sine omega by c into x plus b cos omega by c into x. It is very lengthy, that's why we are not going to do the proof. And your g, which is function of time again, is c sine omega by omega t plus d cos omega t. Actually, we have in our 12th class, we have one basic idea. There we have oscillation and wave. Here in engineering, we have oscillation and vibration. But this transfer displacement is very similar to wave equation. That's why here wave number is coming into picture. Okay, so you can see total how many variables we got. We got our constants, you see A, B, C and D, four constants we got. Now we have to multiply this entire equation with this entire equation, and after the multiplication of both the equations, you will be getting the main equation of yt. Now in that main equation of yt, you will be having four variables, four other unknowns, a1 a2 a3 a4. Now that equation I'm not writing because that is very lengthy and not it is not advisable to go in that direction, because you know gate exam is more about the right direction. So that's why I'm skipping this. Now a1 a2 a3 a4, these values how will you find out? So by using boundary condition, those values we find out, and then we will go back to our partial differential equation, and we will simplify that equation, see how many steps are involved, and then we'll be getting our final equation. Okay, so now you change the, just after this you write a big heading H, skip the derivation. You write the big heading as skip the derivation, and then I will change the page. Then you write here direct solution after appropriate boundary condition. Now see, in our given diagram looks like this, right? This is fixed beam type condition. So at y is equal to 0, sorry, at x is equal to 0 and at t is equal to any time, here your y displacement will be 0. At x is equal to L distance and t is equal to any time t, your y displacement is again 0. You have displacement only in the remaining part of the beam. I mean, at the extreme points, you don't have displacement. So these particles are not vibrating. So these two people will become our boundary condition. So smartly, you have to choose boundary condition. It will vary beam to beam. I'm sorry, different cases. Like we have fixed, we have fixed free, we have free. So in all the cases, you will be having separate ideas. I mean separate boundary conditions. So I will give you a list of boundary condition. Like in this case, this is your boundary condition. This boundary condition, you will write like this. Y bracket 0 comma t is equal to 0 and y bracket L comma t is equal to 0. At t is equal to any time t. This means at t is equal to any time t. So see, y at 0x and at any time t is 0. Y at L means when x was L, and at t is 0. So these two became your boundary condition for this condition. What I have taken in the beginning, vibration of a string. So For the case of vibration of a string, now when we solve this entire boundary condition, we get a solution. So now let's understand solution, and from that solution, how to find out frequency. You see how many steps are involved. Our main job is to find out omega n. So still we have to find out equation of the frequency, and then we have to find out omega n. Okay?